In this lesson, we'll use the debugger to inspect step-by-step the requests to retrieve, update, and create contacts. Let's start by adding a couple of breakpoints in our application, and let me add a breakpoint in the preparation of the contact screen, and another one here in the title, and on the contact detail. Sorry, also here on the search, and on the contact detail, also in the preparation, in the screen, so here in the if, for instance, say the breakpoint here, and also on the save action. Let's start the debugger. And let's open the application. Okay, so we're stopped in the preparation. Our local variable is empty. We haven't fetched anything from the database, so the list in my aggregate is empty. Let me step over and this one. And now we have the contacts fetched from the database matching that search keyword, and in this case, since we haven't filled the search keyword, this will return all the contacts. And now let me continue. We will stop in the screen, so once the preparation ends, we have the server side rendering, and we're going, let me just step over, and we're going to render all these widgets one by one, the input, and now the table records. And let's see here that the table records list is empty. Let's start rendering the table records. And now we already have the results there. The binding occurred. And now, if we go into the in-use, you'll notice that the current property of the list is pointing to Alfred Kammeyer. So this is the contact that it's being rendered at this time. Let me just go through this. And the next one, Anthony Erickson, and so on. So we can just continue. Okay, so now we can search for Joanna. Search. And again, we have the local variable holds the value. We don't need to do anything in the screen action. Let's continue. And we're stopped again in the preparation. Keyword holds the value, Joanna. We're going to step over and execute the aggregates. And now the list of the aggregate has Joanna, and we can continue. We will render the screen again, all of the widgets on the screen, and send the response back to the browser. And there we have it, Joanna. Let's edit now the record. And what happens here, we're stopped in the preparation of the contact detail. We received as an input for this screen the contact ID, number one there. We're going to use this variable to fetch that contact from the database. So let's step over. And now on the aggregate list, we're going to have only one result, Joanna Rivera, there it is. And we can continue. And now we are going to render the screen. We are testing if the contact ID is empty or not. It isn't, it has a value. So this is going to render Joanna Rivera, this expression. So it's getting the value from the aggregate. And let's continue. It's going to render the form, and it's going to use the form record property to bind to these inputs to render on the screen. Let's continue. And there we have it. Now we can edit these notes, for instance, and let's save. And again, here we are in the breakpoint. The widget variable, the record property here, has the contact, And as you can see, it has the values that the user changed in the user interface. And this is the record. Let's go back here to the inUse. This is the record that we're going to use as input for as the source parameter of the create or update contact, which in this case is looking into the ID. So it's looking into this contact and determining if this contact is in the database. If it is, which is the case, it will update Joanna Rivera in the database there, and we will go back into the contact. So let's continue. And we are in the preparation of the contact screen. Step over. Let me just show you that the local variable is empty now. So this is a new request. The value is not maintained between requests. And we're going to use the aggregate to fetch the contacts from the database. And again, render them on the screen. Let's just continue this one. And here we are back in the contacts, and Joanna Rivera is here. Now, let's create a new contact. Again, we're going to run the preparation. In this case, the contact ID is empty. This zero here means that it's empty. So when we fetch the contact from the database, there is no contact in the database whose identifier is zero. So this list is actually empty. And this means that on the screen, this condition will be tested and the value is empty. So we're going to render the new contact, and the form is bound to the result of the aggregate. But in this case, since we have no contact, we're going to have an empty contact to fill in these inputs and so that the user can create a new contact. So let me just step over this. And here in the inUse, here we have it, no name, no phone number, and so on. And we can continue, go back to the screen, and we can now create Alfred Pine and phone number 555555555. Email alfredpine@gmail.mail, company Google, and let's save it. And when we save, again, we're on the same action. We are going to receive the record from the form. And as you can see here, we have Alfred, all the data that I entered in the form. We have no identifier because we are going to create this contact in the database, and it's the database that it's going to populate this identifier with a number automatically provisioned by the database. So let's step over, let's continue to the contacts, again run the preparation. We're just going to continue, render the screen, and there we have Alfred Pine with all the data that I entered. That's it.